Hello everyone, in today's video I will talk about the printing module in PhotoDirector. Once you have finished editing, you can print out high resolution copies in the print module. Click on the print button to open the print module. You can print out photos one at a time or print multiple photos on a single page. There is four sections in the settings panel: layout, image, print settings and the watermark section. In the layout section, you can customize the layout, select the desired paper size. This should match the type of a paper you are going to use to print your photos on. Select whether to print off each page in landscape or portrait mode. If you'd like to include multiple photos on a printed page, use the page grid sliders. Set the number of rows and columns you want in the page grid. I set 2x2 because I have 4 images. The cell size is the placeholder of our photos. If the cell size is not correct, you can set it using the height and width sliders in the cell size section. You can choose the preferred measurement unit you want to use for the cell size, inches or centimeters. Then simply drag the images into empty position. In the image settings section, you can customize how photos are displayed on the page. If you look at the placement of the images, you can see that depending on the aspect ratio of the image, it doesn't always fill the empty space. Click on Zoom to Fit option to auto zoom in on each photo so it fits in the cell. Using the hide grid lines, you are able to hide the grid lines that display on the printed page that help you with the layout. The last option is the rotate to fit. This option finds the best orientation of the image to fit in the cell. As you can see, I checked this option, but nothing was modified. Change the paper orientation to portrait. The images are cropped and looks weird. Now select the rotation option. The algorithm finds the best image orientation in the cell. Great. In the print settings section, you can set the number of copies to be printed, select the printer and set the photo resolution. Print resolution is simply the level of detail in the printed image. Higher resolution means higher detail and can be measured in pixel per inch, PPI. An image with a higher PPI tends to be higher quality because it has a greater pixel density, but exporting at 300 PPI is generally considered industry standard quality. This is perfect resolution for all printing materials. What is an ICC profile? This is the abbreviation of International Color Consortium. It can be very frustrating when what you get on paper doesn't match what you see on a screen. Your monitor can display a different range of colors from that which the printer and paper can manage. ICC profiles act as a translation between the source set of colors in the digital image and the destination on screen or in print. Advanced users who want the highest degree of color control will want to generate their own ICC profiles using profiling application available from independent software vendors. By creating custom profiles, user can color correct for the exact paper, print cartridges and printer that they are using. You can set your own color profiles in Windows, open Printers and Scanner Settings dialog, find your printer and hit Manage. Click on Printer Properties link. Then open the Color Management tab and click on Color Management button. In the Color Management dialog, select the All Profiles tab and click on Add button. Here you can load any ICC profile saved on the disk. Go back to Devices tab, check the Use My Settings for this device option. The Add button will be available below. Click on Add and select the desired profile, for example sRGB. Select your printer from the list box. Then select the same ICC profile using the Add button if the recently selected is not listed. Then close the dialogs. In this way, we set our custom ICC profile on monitor and also on the printer. And last but not least, if required, you can add watermark templates to all of the photos you print. You can choose from a number of PhotoDirector watermarks or use custom watermarks you created in the watermark creator. If there is no need to use the watermark, uncheck this option. The profile section is similar as the manual section, only one difference is here. Instead of selecting the number of rows and columns, you can select from the list of predefined photo size. If the photo size you want is not available on the drop-down list, select the Enter Custom option to manually set it. Enter the desired width and length in the fields available and then click OK to set it. The algorithm will calculate the best layout for your defined image size for printing automatically. If you are done with the layout, hit print button in the left bottom to initiate the print. If you want to print a single image for a photo frame, set the number of cells to 1. Select the appropriate paper size, then the cell size which corresponds with the required image size. You can add watermark, then print it. Put it into the picture frame, then place the picture on the wall in your room. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe for more and see you in the next time. Bye.